Hey YouTube, Coppersan here. Today we're ramming through these levels as we train the newest class Lera to level 200 in EU Reboot. We're starting off in Lera's hometown where we complete the quests around here. You can teleport out of this area if you want to, but hey, I was in the mood for holding down NPC chat for a while, so what the heck, I just went through it. The quests here are all kill and collect quests with quests like don't get sadder, get a letter, letters are chaos and the letter of success, so you know what you can expect. Thankfully for Lera, winter wasn't coming, so we can power through this tutorial area pretty easily. First job Lera is kinda slow. We learn both our damage reduction and jump skills, and we learn the acid sprinkle attack, which is our main mobbing skill that we will be using up until level 300. When using acid sprinkle, there also is a chance for your mountain kits to appear to dish out additional damage. This is your main mobbing skill in first job, but later on it will become sort of a additional mobbing skill. We'll talk about it in a bit. With first job done, we crank things up a notch and we're now level 32 by the time we leave the starter area. Make sure to take a look at your event quest notifier at the left side of your screen, as there will be a level 30 support gift waiting for you. This gift contains a free level 30 equipment set and some inventory slot coupons. Reaching level 30, we unlock team dungeons, and there's only one thing we say to those: not today. I already had my fill of holding down NPC chat for today, so I'm just not gonna do that. If you are not far yet with building up your account, like getting all those link skills and legion effects, I do recommend actually playing through team dungeons to get some nice accessories, mesos and spell traces. But because I do have a lot of legion link skills and EXP buffs prepared, we're just gonna grind instead. Lera really comes online once she hits level 30. Her grinding is absolutely broken. With one push of a button, she can clear entire maps. Also, fun fact, if you have more summon duration, those eruptions will not last longer, but instead they'll deal more damage. The summons deal 1% more damage for every 2% summon duration. So for example, with a level 200 Corsair Legion effect that gives 10% summon duration, your summons will deal an additional 5% damage. Leveling on Lera goes extremely fast, and it will go even faster once we reach 4th job. I grinded the Wild Boars Empyrean after leveling a Savage Terminal, and I trained from level 55 to level 57 at the inside of an old ruin at the Skeledox map, and then hit level 60 at, of course, the Copper Sandrakes. I was lucky to find a map, feels like everyone is making a Lera today. Also, make sure to turn on automatic casting for your 2nd job Mountain Seed skill. Every time you'll use an eruption skill, you'll automatically plant one of those. It's not gonna do a lot, but hey, all the little bits help. Leveling was a breeze, really. Second job is amazing. Third job, on the contrary, feels a bit like the final season of Game of Thrones. Okay, it ain't that bad, but we're not getting anything super flashy like in second job anymore. Third job is all about learning new supportive skills, buffing the damage of your vein eruptions, and the damage of your earth-based skills. I didn't really use the blue buff that often, where you can like create a stream of water to travel through by using like two blue veins, but the red and green buffs are super useful. They increase your damage and attack speed, so make sure to use those as often as you can. After training at Stairway to the Sky 1 in Orbis and the Desert of Serenity, I went to Rats in the Ludi Tower. Most Lera skills have pretty amazing vertical range, so with just 3 summons, it was pretty easy to cover a big part of this map without any issues. We wrap things up over at the Rash in Lifre, and this map I personally didn't really like with Lera. No monsters spawn at the entire bottom part of the map, but your veins do, which can be kinda inconvenient and disruptive. Speaking of negatives, also Lera, her up jump can be a bit clunky, and you cannot erupt veins in the air. But besides that, hey, no complaints so far, really liking this class. We collapse the Coom for a few free levels and activate the Winter event that is currently running. And also, we got a new reward from the Lera leveling support event, a free level 100 Frozen set, and a title that gives some additional Star Force that will be super useful later on, so we can actually do the 5th job advancement. We can now also wear the totems that we have gotten from the Lera pre-registration event. Keep in mind that those only last for 30 days. Our next goal is to reach level 141, so we can use those level up potions and hopefully gain a lot of time. Each potion can grant between 1 and 10 levels, and the higher your level, the lower your chances are for getting more levels. So we want to get those ASAP and also use them ASAP. We trained at Dual Ghost Pirates and Junior Cerebus in the Deadmine. In 4 job, your Vein Eruption summons get even more range and damage, and Lera's grinding just gets absolutely ridiculous. I don't think I've ever reached the end of the Stormwing base map this fast on any class. I don't think this class will take over Kanna's grinding speeds or anything like that, like Kanna's still MVP of course, but it is pretty insane. Reaching level 142, because I wanted to finish a rune, I teleported to Hennessy's to take a look at the Lera store. You can access this store through the start notifier on the left side of your screen as Lera. None of these rewards are tradable though, so you will have to use them on your Lera, except for the job change coin and the cape coupon. But I will be buying mostly node stones and symbols for this class. Anyway, the moment of truth. 1 level. 2 levels. 3 levels. 5 levels, and again 2 levels, wow. I think I just had the worst luck of anyone ever. My disappointment is immeasurable and my day is absolutely ruined. I hope no one suffers the same fate as me, but if you did kind of suffer the same fate and you want to start training, Blue Notebooks at the Curling Tower are pretty decent. I was so sad, I just started training right away, not thinking about anything anymore, but after a few levels I realized that there are some more rewards waiting for me. At level 150 you will get a full Fafnir set, this is time limited, so make sure to get spares before the time runs out. I used the trade potion to get more charm to unlock my pocket slot, and you can get a box containing EXP cards, so you're gonna grind even faster now. I also fought Horntail for a free level up and some boss accessories, and at level 172 I went to the first map in Kritios. Around level 178 I went to check out Hall of Honor in Future Ereve, but I got one shot by an elite mob there, that's no joke. Lara does not have a lot of HP. Because more and more Laras were crowding around at higher level training spots, I figured it was better to go to a less popular off the grid map, and this map called Forest of Lament too. That was pretty nice for Lara. If you're looking for more training spots, there should be a card appearing right about now with a training spot guide. Around level 188, I went to the Flutter Bus in Fox Valley. These maps here have high burning, and with a totem spawn is pretty good. Also, by the way, don't forget about your hyper stats. I went for level 10 damage against normal monsters and critical damage because I already had max crit rate. If your crit rate is low, I recommend spending more points there before upping your crit damage. For inner abilities, Lara prefers passive skills plus 1. Lara gets a dummy thick amount of final damage from a forge of passive skills, so boosting that and her other passive is always amazing. And after a long 5-hour grind, we finally made it. Man, I miss burning. The Flutter Bus carried us all the way to level 199 and 50%, and the final 50% we of course always get from the Scrapyard Introduction quest. During our special level 200 quest, we actually meet MapleStory's Yasuo and get our hero's Echo skill. One newer change that is also pretty awesome when you're doing your 5th job advancement is that you can now go directly to Magnus instead of having to figure out how to actually go to Easy Magnus. This is a special Magnus boss that is weaker, doesn't drop anything, and can only be accessed by you. And we're 5th job, just like that, and Lara gets a ton of burst skills in her 5th job. Overall, this is a really nice class with a few minor things that I didn't really like the up jump and that you can't use your vein eruption skills in the air and things like that. But overall, amazing grinding, great burst, and some supportive skills as well. Her off burst isn't that great though, but you know, you can't have it all. She has her own bind and a skill that reduces incoming damage to protect you from some boss attacks. I am training this class to level 220, so I will post a follow-up video as soon as that's done. If you have time, then I recommend doing that as well, because the Lara support event rewards a fake Absolep weapon box or Dominator pendant box that can be traded within the account, as well as a gift box that contains free node stones and arcane symbols once per week, so that's definitely worth it. So, to be continued, and that was all for today for now. As always, many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Thanks to Niels de Konnik, Rama Waar, Sebastian Hanoi, FLX, Rylias, Terry Kim, Varese, Claudie Mora, Wiley, Francisco Sousa, History Cannon, Backspace OTI, Sophronix, Lonzo, BG Extremes, Anwar NHI, Frank Bouguet, Ziggy Deer, Flidiot, BeamerWT, Knifesu, Chen125, Cloudfix, Gusus Rodriguez, Froggy11, Sir Tito655, Glason, Brandon Cam, Vira, Trevor, Michael Machaca, Ratius, Lucky Beats, Justin Vale, Silvio Nato, Stevie Zhang, Afterlord underscore MS, Heopan, Simak, Joshua Alvarez, Striker Elk, NockMSS, Niu, Tide1 Pan, Victor Sundstrom, Radicals the Alien, Stanislaus Kusumo Vegas, Ricer RU, Eddie Reacts to Things, Dular, Gummy Bullet, Leon Reddle, Booty Warrior GT, Jeremy Stodler, and Mr. Narc. Thank you all so much for watching. Stay safe and happy mapling!